You want to see mine? Shit. That one's from a sneeze. Slipped and cut too deep. Almost cut my Achilles.
Why?
Shite being Scottish! We're the lowest of the low! The scum of the fucking earth! The most wretched, miserable, servile, pathetic trash that was ever shot!
Like so many others, I had become a slave to the IKEA nesting instinct.
Yes. I'd like to order the Erica Picari dust ruffles.
If I saw something clever, like a little coffee table in the shape of a yin-yang, I had to have it. The Klipsk personal office unit, the Hovatrek home exerbike, or the Ohanishov sofa with the string green stripe pattern, even the Rizlampa wire lamps of environmentally friendly unbleached paper. I'd flip through catalogs and wonder, what kind of dining set defines me as a person? I had it all, even the glass dishes with tiny bubbles and imperfections, proof that they were crafted by the honest, simple, hardworking indigenous peoples of wherever.
I was holding.
I am ungrateful. You call me ungrateful. My life has been stolen from me. I'm living in a town I have no wish to live in. I'm living a life I have no wish to live. How did this happen? It is time for us to move back to London.
Are you happy with your new book?
You know how I am.
I miss London.
I mean, I feel like it's true to what I set out to do, so I'm happy about that.
I miss London life.
Yeah, well, you really are your own worst critic. I'm sure it's amazing.
This is not you speaking, Virginia. This is an aspect of your illness.
It's
not
is,
you.
It is my voice.
It's not your voice.
It's mine and mine
it's
alone.
The voice that you hear.
It is not! It is mine! I'm dying in this town!
Thinking clearly, Virginia, you'd recall it was London that brought you low.
If I'm thinking clearly. If I were thinking clearly.
We brought you to Richmond to give you peace.
If I were thinking clearly, Leonard, I would tell you that I wrestle alone in the dark, in the deep dark, and that only I can know. Only I can understand my own condition. You live with the threat, you tell me. You live with the threat of my extinction. Leonard, I live with it too. This is my right. It is the right of every human being. I choose not the suffocating anesthetic of the suburbs, but the violent jolt of the capital. That is my choice. The meanest patient, yes, even the very lowest, is allowed some say in the matter of her own prescription. Thereby she defines her humanity.
But the hopelessness you're feeling is a symptom, and we have to leave that in the past. A psychologist once said, depression is an inability to construct a future.
What meds are you on?
Me?
Well, Butrin, Prozac, Effexor, really struggled.
Hmm.
I remember she had problems with sleep, nausea, chills.
I'm putting on Zoloft.
He's made me sick, too. I had better luck with Celexa.
I used to be on lithium and Seroquel and Abilify, but I don't take them anymore, no. They make me foggy, and they also make me bloated.
Yeah, I was on Xanax and Effexor, but I agree, it wasn't as sharp.
Purple in the morning.
You ever take Klonopin?
Blue in the afternoon.
Right?
Jeez.
Orange in the evening.
Yeah.
What day is it? How about Trazodone?
Trazodone?
Oh, it flattens you out. I mean, you are done. It takes the light right out of your eyes.
God, I bet it does.
Can't she stop taking drugs? Isn't there an alternative approach?
No. God, no. I can finally sleep. I have some energy. We had sex. It was like we were actually together.
Maybe something else would do the same thing.
Absolutely. There are still other SSRIs, SNRIs.
No. I've tried everything else. You don't know, Martin. You've never had this. You don't know what it's like.
What the hell is going on? Richard?
What are you doing here? You're early.
What is going on here? What are you doing?
I had this wonderful idea. I needed some light. I needed to let in some light.
Richard, what are you doing?
I had this fantastic notion. I took this Xanax and the Ritalin together. It never occurred to me.
Richard!
Don't come near me! It seemed to me I needed to let in some light.
When you have insomnia, you're never really asleep. And you're never really awake.
Somebody to fuck me. I want somebody to want me to fuck them. Maybe that would have filled this time. Tiny little hole in my heart, but probably not. And sometimes I think I've felt everything I'm ever gonna feel. And from here on out, I'm not gonna feel anything new. Just
lesser versions of what I've already felt.
I know for a fact that is not true. I've seen you feel joy. I've seen you marvel at things. I mean, you just might not see it at this exact time, but that's understandable. You've been through a lot lately. You lost a part of yourself. I mean, at least your feelings are real.